call and response. What is it?
Yeah, this is an exhibition that we've organised using members of the Five Ways Artist Group. And the exhibition is called Call and Response. And it was an exhibition that was set up and took 8 months to complete. The project lasted from the beginning of the COVID epidemic. And how it works is that each artist in the Five Ways Artist Group made an initial piece of artwork. They took that piece of artwork and they passed it on to someone that they knew, who looked at it, didn't copy it, but made a response to it, their own response. And they took their response and sent it on, to someone else who sent it on. So it became an ongoing chain of creativity across, basically, three lockdowns.
Incredible. And I can see from your hill, you've got 216 cooperators, creators.
That's right,
32 weeks, 12 paths.
Mm-hmm.
Three lockdowns,
yeah.
One single community. That's an incredible achievement.
The community is largely based on Brighton artists, but the exhibition's been as far abroad as Spain. It then came back to England. It's been up the north of England, south of England. So it is a nationwide, it's got nationwide contributions from a whole range of different artists, different materials, different ways of looking at things, different ages.
The original 12, where do you guys got the ideas from, and is there anything in particular you guys want to
Well, I suppose I kind of felt when we were in the very first lockdown that though you'd meet people that you knew, sometimes, quite well, you always used to have a conversation that focused on how you were getting down, how you're getting on down in lockdown. So it was to do with, have you got enough toilet paper? How you manage to get the food that you need, how are your children doing, all that sort of thing. And I kind of became rather inept at holding those conversations. So I wanted to give people a bit of space rather than confronting someone in a conversation. I wanted to set up a conversation that was done at a distance, but with that kind of feeling of intimacy that you get when you're a creative person. And I suppose in many ways, artists aren't always brilliant at using words. What we do, our chosen pathway, if you like, is to be creative. So it seems logical for me to do a conversation with people, but a conversation across the medium of creativity.
You mentioned all the artwork. It's produced from famous artists to potential...
I really recognised in lockdown and with the whole pandemic that no one's exempt, that we're all kind of on an even footing. And you can be someone that's very wealthy, you can be someone living on the streets. And I wanted to make the exhibition inclusive in that same sort of way. So we've got children from primary school that have never done a piece of artwork and had it on exhibition before. We've got people that have never touched a paintbrush in their life. We've got people that sell work for £200 or £300 at a time. It suits the exhibition because everyone is on a level playing field. So it's quite astounding, coming in. And myself, I know probably about 20% of the artists that take part, but 80% of the artists I've never met in my life. And yet, through having organised the exhibition, I do feel some sort of kind of, affinity. And just the whole sense of, energy and the whole sense of joy, the sense of humour, commitment, fortitude, resilience, all those things, I think really come over in the show. And for me, that's what made it such a special exhibition to organise.
You mentioned all the art is for sales and it is for a charity?
Yeah, the artists have all done the work and taken part and they've all donated their work. And what we've asked people to do is if they want to buy a piece of work, it's available for £25, but so many people have bought a piece of work and said, well, the piece of work is, to me, it's worth more than £25. So a lot of people have been really generous in upping their donation. And we're giving all the proceeds to an organisation called the Brighton and Hove Food Partnership. And they deal with health, mental health and physical health. And they deal with well-being. They deal with food and nutrition. They deal with people that are learning to cook for the first time. They deal with people cooking on a low income, people with learning difficulties. So they are really contributing a lot to, you know, Brighton as a community in the situation in which we still find ourselves.
We also are in a beautiful venue here.
This is St. Augustine's Church. It's on the corner of Stamford Avenue in Brighton. And the lovely thing about exhibiting here at this kind of time of post-lockdown is that talking to the manager here, he was saying how during the First World War and the Second World War, St. Augustine's Church acted as a medical centre. And when the first wave of vaccinations were administered, St. Augustine's was one of the very first venues to make themselves available for people to come and get vaccinated. So I would say 30, 40, 50 old people getting out of taxis, getting out of minibuses, and they were all lining up outside the venue. So the venue in these times as well is something that's quite special.